Recording, here we go. One, what's the date? 1-8. Happy early birthday to Nicole. It's on Sunday. We are recording Friday morning. Oh, my clock went a little off. Friday morning, it is our first 45 seconds of our warm-up. We're doing some jumping jacks, a jump rope, whatever works for you guys. And, what else? 6:02, started a few seconds late, but now we move into our lunge and reach. Anything late doesn't matter for guys at home, though. We got recorded version. You start when you start. It's all good. Everyone good at home? Everyone have a good week? First week of the year. Craziness going on in the world, but we're going to keep on being solid here and getting stuff done, getting our workouts in, getting people healthy, keeping people moving. All right, I got a couple actually new people here in class today, first week, and I have to jump out of here a couple times to give them some assistance. I don't know, right? We go to our sumo. All right. Lunge and reach. We got all the machines out there today. We got ladders. We got Hosu. We got Swiss. So, again, you guys will have to be creative with your cardio today if you don't have a machine at home. Because we are doing jump ropes. You can do extra jump rope. You can do, I mentioned, a half a bunny if you wanted to do for your cardio for station one. Instead of a full bunny, it's just, it would be this two squat jumps and two lunge jumps. We do have the ladders. You can make that up, ladders. Soon we got inchworm is up next. Slowly walk the hands out. And slowly walk the hands back up. And what else? So ladders, you guys can make believe in ladders. That's easy enough. Not many people might have a Bosu or a Swiss ball at home. So I think I showed the modifications on the video. So if you haven't watched the video yet and you need any modifications, watch the video first for the hamstring curls. I made a modification for that. Everything else can kind of be done on the ground. You got a post, you got a slam ball. You can do most of those exercises on the ground. We move to our butterfly stretch. But yeah, it's definitely doable at home if you don't have a machine or a Bosu or Swiss ball. A lot of cardio, lots of cardio. Any kind of weight will work for station C. And lots of core work for D, so we'll make it happen, right? We'll make it work. Right now we're stretching. We got a big stretch of stretching going on right now. Butterfly stretch, open up that groin area, get a good stretch in there, press on the insides of the knees with the elbows. Try to keep that back nice and straight. Three more seconds there. Then we move to our side lunge to our instep stretch. Side lunge to instep. You know that. Nice deep side lunge, turn, go to your instep. Make sure we get both sides. That instep stretch, very important. Open up those hamstrings. And hip flexors. Gotta get those hip flexors. And we go to our IT band stretch. So one foot crosses over the other, and we bend. Alright, got a nice stretch with that. Make sure you're using both sides. Then we're gonna go to our high knees and heel kicks after that. High knees and heel kicks after that. your high knees and heel kicks. Get nice range of motion. Good, get a nice range of motion. That's it, keep those knees pumping, get those heels to the butt. And now we go to our chest and knee to chest. Clerical work over here real quick, so you guys stretch amongst yourselves. Finish with a little jack in the box or some jump rope. All right, guys, if they finish this up, I'm going to go out and make sure they're good. I have to show some exercises on the ladders. Not that sure, set the clock up. So give me a second. Cardio, doing some calories. So again, this is where you can figure out what you want to do. Some half bunnies, squat jump, 180, and lunge jump. And you know, these guys are gonna be on these machines for about 90 seconds on average. Let's work on the cardio and get that heart rate up. Again, you can be doing jumping rope if you want. You can be jumping jacks, jack in the box. You can be saving some of your cardio. Go out and do a run or a bike later. works for you. So I think we're probably going to go a little bit less on our numbers than most people. And let's see, maybe 30 people will get to? I don't know. I can't imagine many people going to 40 today. It's been a while. But we'll see. Now, you people at home who have machines, I know a couple of you got rowers and bikes. You guys can break out your big calories. Like starting on that bike, Henry. How does that feel? How does that feel? Oh, we've got a wobbly bike. I need to update that bike. All right, so we go to our hamstring curls. Hamstring curls on that ball. Hamstring curls again. That modification I put out in the video, it's kind of the same thing with the hamstring curls. You're walking your feet out and you're walking your feet back from your shoulders on the ground with the hips up. Hopefully you guys can stop this, watch that real quick and know what you're doing. Now we're on to our ladder exercises. So again, all you need is about 5-6 feet of space in your basement, in your workout room, and you can put some blue tape down if you need to kind of makeshift what a ladder would look like, or just use your imagination. Right, so we're going with our straight up lateral back. So up is one, back is two. So we do four lengths of that. Our 1-2-1, up and back, up and back. Now we're on our hopscotch. As Henry's on his hopscotch. We have a lateral switch as well. So then we finish that up. And now we do our lateral hand walk with our push-up. You see Henry now is on that. So you're kind of walking through, getting a push-up in every time your hand moves. Nice rhythm, nice pace he's got going on. And that's what we're looking for right there. Just kind of, this is the only time we're doing our push-up. So if you're doing the full set, I think you're getting about 20 in. All right, 1, 2, 3, 4. And 5, you did that 4 times, so that's 20 push-ups real quick. Woo, beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. Now we got Slurpees, Slurpee Slurpees. Got a slam ball, he's got a slam ball. Did not remember his slam ball. He's gotta go get his slam ball. So again, if you guys don't have a slam ball at home, burpees will be fine. It's just 10 burpees, and then you can use whatever weight you have, and you pretty much do it on the ground. Your half moons, your walk-ups, offset squat, you have a box or some way to raise 1 foot or just regular squats. So if you have to, then you have your rear elevated split squats. Again, that could be done on the ground, boxes that you have, that'll work. And this is our slurpee, right guys? We slam that ball, we kick those feet back, we come back up, and we lift, and we do it again. 10 of those. Nice, nice, nice. Keeping that breath in line, right? This will get the heart rate up pretty quick. Do your best, breathe, breathe, breathe. Nice job, nice job. So we did groiners on Wednesday's workout, right? That's like a half a burpee, and then we did slams, side slams. So it's kind of a little combination of those two, so you guys shouldn't be too in the dark on that one. And then we do our half moon, right? So you're standing on that Bosu. All right, we have our half moons. Like I said, I got Jim in the background. He's going to be demonstrating what to do without the Bosu. He is, again, new this week, and I just can't have someone brand new trying a Bosu exercise when you're not used to that. The black side of the Bosu is a tricky side, so we want to make sure we're knowing what to do. Now we got our jump rope. Now we got our jump rope time. You guys got jump ropes at home? We should all have jump ropes. There we go. See that clock? And we do our jump rope. Now we can see the time. Well, I can see the minutes, kind of see the seconds. I hope this works enough for people to be able to see. So you guys got clocks at home, you guys got watches, you got phones, you got a timer, all good stuff to get your heart rate up. Little jumpy jumps, little jumpy jumps. And this will be done with round one. We're doing five rounds, so yes, we are going to be moving here. We are going to be moving. It is a fast pace, no doubt. It'll get the heart rate up for sure. Full minute and a half, maybe 2 minutes. Don't pay attention, but we got our jump rope in. Nice job, Henry. Nice job. And now we go to triangle sit-ups. Triangle sit-ups. Ten aside on your triangle sit-ups. That's all. Cross one ankle over the knee and bring the shoulders up off the ground as you bring that leg up in the air. Attempting to get your elbows as close to your knees or your forehead as close to your knees as you can. Keeping that leg as straight as possible. That'll complete round one. What's the time? What time? What time? 6:20. That's good. That's good pace. And that is a good pace. We probably started around 12 past, so 8 minutes is our goal per round. So we are looking good, I think. We are looking good. All right. I think so. A little good time wise. Yeah. What did you do for calories? Yeah. Yeah. I mean, I think that might have been faster than 8 minutes. So I think we're good. Yo, boy. All right. Made a little maintenance on the bike. Screwing our legs, making sure we get a nice solid base. Ah, now we're good. Now we're good. All right, so we're gonna see how well we can keep this base. We definitely were cruising there. Whether or not we can keep it up, we'll see. But everyone else is all on to their cardio now, so. Yes, we're looking good. We're looking good. All right, just had to double check with Henry, make sure he's not gonna trying to kill himself with the camera because he was a little out of breath after that first round, but I wasn't sure if we could keep up that pace. And I was like, yeah, look, we have to keep up that pace. We got some time. If we did 9-minute rounds from here on out, 9 times 4 is 36. And, you know, we have 38 minutes, so we're looking good. We're looking good. All right. Whew. Fast and furious today. This is a good old-fashioned Fast Friday. All right, second round on the machines. Again, crank out our calories. And if we can get to that 30 mark, I think you're doing pretty good. I threw the 40 out there just because, well, if we ever want to repeat this workout in the future, we know if we're in good shape, we can do 40. Right now, not that we're not in good shape, because you guys are, but when you're not used to the machine doing 40 calories, well, you know the deal. It takes a little bit acquainting to these machines to get used to that kind of number again. So we'll stick to maybe 30 and be fine with that. Something to build up for, all right? This is why we can't shut down. We can't take away people's ability to work out, because step backwards in health is counterproductive to what we're trying to do, keeping ourselves healthy. So that's all I have to say about that. We have a V-up ball switch coming up next. I've had this mask on the whole time. I'm sorry if I feel muffled. If I sounded muffled, I just realized my mask has been on the whole time. V-up ball switch. So if you don't have a ball, just a V-up toe touch, right? That'll work. But with the ball, we're bringing it up with our hands, putting it in our feet, and switching. All right. And your V-up toe touches will be 20. Obviously, you modify as need to for your numbers, but anyone that's home with their Swiss ball, trying to do this switch action. Raise the legs, the ball in between. Grab it with your hands all the way down. Switch back and forth. Whew. Nice. Then we go back to our ladders, right? Some ladder work. Straight up, lateral back. All right, we're gonna take over the square. Maybe we have extra room. Actually, yeah. So you're gonna be coming straight at you. So 2 feet straight up and lateral on the way back. Here we go. We got one up, lateral back is 2. We got 3. We got 4. Facing the other way. Boom, to our 1-2-1. Oh, lateral switch. We're going lateral switch. Yeah, I wrote it in a way that you can interpret which direction you're gonna go to, lateral switch or 1-2-1. And everybody's doing the lateral switch. And then we have our 1-2-1, 1 outside, 2 in the middle, quick feet. And then we finish with the hopscotch. So this is the reason why I wanted to go straight, lateral back, 1-2-1, forward and back, lateral switch, and then hopscotch, because 1-2-1 and hopscotch are too similar. But that's all right. Now we do our front hand walk with the hands in and out. So Henry is doing the lateral hand walk in and out. He's on round 4. That's all right. That was round, you did round 4. Round 2, you're walking this way. That's all right. Switching rounds up. Anything that's new is gonna be a little getting used to. We haven't done a whole lot of hand stuff in the ladders, so no biggie. But now we're on the slurpees. Get to 10 slurpees, no straw required. And then we do our walk up on the ball. This is a new one. I figured I'd give it a shot. See how it tries, see how it works out. It's a little balanced, a little tricky, but you're not going down nearly as far. So I figured, why not? See how it feels. See, a couple people here are trying it. So it's a little more balance needed than normal, but it's not as low as you need to go. So I think you can get a little more of a rhythm. We'll see. We'll have to take a survey on this one, see what people think of that. I'm not convinced it's going to be something that we keep. But, you know, can't find out if things are good unless you try it. So if you got a BOSU at home and you're giving this a shot, let me know what you think. If you like the walk up on the BOSU, it's definitely going to be easier on the knees. All right, it's a nice soft landing to get on. So that could be a bonus. And Henry's on the gray one, which is a little rougher, but it's still soft on the knees. Maybe a little gruff on the knees, but it's not the hard ground. So, all right, 20 of them. We're good. All right. We're done with those. Moving on to jump rope. All right. We're using all the space in our square today, so make sure we got room. Here we go. Where are we at? 21, just started. 22, I should say. From 22, we're counting down. Good. Everybody's getting up there now. Whew. Nice job, guys. Nice job. Good. Find that rhythm, find that pace. Nothing like some jump ropes. If you guys are going to be home for a while longer, I would definitely recommend buying yourself a jump rope or two if you don't have one. Why do I say two? Well, someone else in the house might want to join you, right? All right, now we go to our side plank toe touch. Okay, so we're on a good strong side plank. Long leg, long arm, touch that toe. 10 of them on each side. All right. What have we got for music going on? It's going a little slow. I'm going to have to change the music here. Sometimes it changes by itself. Get all the beat on, but. Time eyes. Looking good. You're actually going faster. 60 seconds. That's fine. I mean, I know. All righty, two rounds down. Here we go, round three. Banging out that machine. All right, guys, we're in this thick of it now, so let's keep on moving. Good work, guys. We're cranking. Again, what are you guys doing for your cardio? I know some of you guys have a machine, but those who don't have machines, what are you doing out there? You skipping this portion of it and fast forwarding to the one-legged hip raise so you can do your cardio later. Are you doing extra jumping rope or jumping jacks? Maybe extra burpees. I try to think about other things you guys can do creative-wise to get your heart rate up. Nothing's like a machine, though. I gotta be honest. You know the deal. Nothing is like a bike to get that heart rate up. So hopefully you guys are able to get your cardio in at home. And it's very, very good to be able to get the good combination of the resistance training and the cardio. So, I know it's been, you know, the winter time, so it's not as easy to get outside for your bike rides or for your rollerblades or for your jogs, but those runners out there definitely make do, and then they find the time, they make it happen. So, but for us casual cardio people, it may be a little more of a challenge to get your cardio in. So do your best, though. Do your best. All right. All right. That's all I have to say about that. Now three. Finish up the cardio. We're going to go to a one-legged hip raise. And I should have wrote down shoulders are on the ball for this one because I can see who did not work. Watch the video. They are putting their foot on a elevation. You want your shoulders on the ball. So if you have any, now if you don't have any ball, you can just do a regular hip raise with shoulders on the ground. But the goal is to have your shoulders on the Swiss ball, one leg off the ground, when one leg up. One leg on the ground, one leg up. Shoulders on the ball, shoulders on the ball. Go watch the video. All right, all right, all right. Having fun out there, having fun. It works either way. It's not like you're doing anything wrong by putting your foot on an elevated a box or something like that, but with the shoulders on the ball, it gives you more stability work. And you can definitely work the core a little bit more this way. So we're trying to get the hamstrings and the glutes working. But that is the goal with that. I'm gonna change the music. A little off the pace here, a little off the pace here with the music. Switching up a little bit. And we go to our ladder station again. Ladder station, quick feet moving here. We got our 1-2-1, working forward back to our hopscotch. Quick feet, in and out, up and back, coming back. All right, good, good, good. Now we have our lateral hand walk with a knee tuck. Good, good, good. Boom, that's it. We walk on our hands side to side. Bring the knees up to the elbows. Little knee tuck, little knee tuck. Anyone out there wants to work harder, they can do a pike. Do this with a pike. That'll make it real tough. Nice job, guys. Nice job. Nice job. Finish four lengths of that. We move on to our Slurpees. Slurpee time. Oof. So again, because we did so many push-ups in the beginning, a lot of push-ups in our last workout, and I typically say let's hold off on doing the push-ups on the Swiss, on the slam ball, just so we can get more of a rhythm going. It's more of a cardio thing. We want to bang it out fast. Now, of course, if you want to do your push-ups on the ball, you go right ahead. But again, no ball at home. You guys are doing regular burpees anyways, with or without the push-up. That's up to you. You got to find what's working for you, right? And again, I'm kind of giving you the format. I'm giving you the blueprints. And, you know, the depending on how you want the house to be built, is what you're going to be using for your materials. And by that, I mean, if you want to do the full-on push-up, that's up to you when you do the burpees. Otherwise, you can do no push-up on the burpees, call those burps, or full-on push-ups, or you do the peel push-ups, like you peel yourself up off the ground. But important thing is, we're moving. Now, this is an offset squat. So if you have the ability to raise one foot higher than the other, that's what we're looking for, offset squat. Right? Other than that, you can do regular squats, holding onto your weight. You know, you don't need a slam ball for this. Any weight will work. And finish up our 20 offset squats. We're moving on to the D's round. Jump ropes. Ooh. All right. It is evident. It is a fast Friday. Cardio. Heart rate's up. There we go with our jump rope. Find a time that works for you. 1 minute, minute and a half, 2 minutes. Be really ambitious. I think we've been sticking with a minute here just to make sure we have time, but we're looking good. We must start pretty early because we got 20 minutes left, two rounds. We can do 10 minute rounds and still be on time. Yeah, so we must have been cruising here because I know we started at 6:02. So we probably didn't start the workout until about 11 or 12 past, so. All right. Then we go to our sprinters. Nice, good control here with the sprinters. All right, so head up, chest up, and bring that one arm in. Keep both feet off the ground is the goal. That makes the core constantly engaged. Always working. Nice. All right, guys, good. 20 of your sprinters, you get them all in? Get them all in. No cutting quarters, guys. Obviously, if you're modifying, if you're still slowly getting back into working out, you know, modify as needed. But my veterans out there, don't be skimping on me. So all 20. All right, moving on to round four. Getting that cardio in, guys. We're on the beginning of round four. Moving pretty quick. Looking good. Thank you. cardio wise, I think he's probably getting 30 calories in again. Good, good, good for Henry. Nice job, buddy. Nice job. Way to put it in the time. Way to put it in the time. All right, all right. After this, we're going to be doing a bird dog. On the Swiss ball is nearly impossible, but I still want to put that challenge out there. Most people are going to go to the ground. You can go to your BOSU. Do this on the BOSU for sure. But I always like putting out that challenge just in case some people want to try it. I know Henry was going to give it a shot. One arm, opposite leg. Oh, this will take a little while. This will take a little while. Hold it, hold it. Henry doesn't want to bite it. He's going to hold it. He's going to do his best. One arm, opposite leg. Oh, man, that is tricky. Man, that is tricky. Okay, get ahead of the old college try. Well, that one's not gonna be any easier. BOSU, I'll use the BOSU. All right, we gave it a try. We gave it a try. That is not easy. If you got all the time in the world, you want to practice that, go right ahead. But on the Swiss ball, that's next level stuff. On a fast Friday, when we get time crunch, sometimes you just want to get moving. Keep them moving. Keep them moving. All right, that looks better. That looks better. Nice, nice, nice. All right, on to our ladders. All right, we've got our lateral switch going on with our ladders. Quick feet, up and back, up and back. Good, 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 good. That's it, that's it, that's it. And our 1-2-1, up and back, up and back. 1-2-1, and hopscotch to finish. All right, now we'll go back to our second round. This is where we missed, in the second round. So front hand walk in and out. So now we're walking up and backwards. Hands go in, hands go out. Feet move in, feet move out. Lots of stuff going on, lots of stuff going on. Up and back, up and back. And after this, we'll go to our Slurpees. Nice, nice, nice. All right, all right, all right. Here we go. Another round of Slurpees. Guys at home, doing your burpees, doing your burps. Whatever works. Yeah, we're getting that heart rate up, and we're keeping it up. That's what this Fast Friday is all about. High intensity, cardio, some coordination built in there. Did some heavy stuff on Monday. What kind of Monday? Definitely Wednesday. So today is all about the cardio. Nice, nice, nice. And then we go to our rear elevated split squats, 10 on each side. All right, very limited split squats are 10 on each side. Again, if you don't have any ability to raise your foot, I find that surprising. If you want to, we can obviously just do regular split squats with the weight. Totally fine, totally fine. All right, there we go. Last round of round four. Last station, round four. More jump ropes. Keep an eye on your clock. Get it done, get it done. Nice work, everyone. Nice work, nice work. We got about 11 minutes left on the clock for our hour. We definitely have our time to get this in. Very exciting, very exciting. But let's finish up our jump ropes. And we go to our V up leg drop. Ready. Nice, nice, nice. Got that in. Now they're getting the V up leg drop. So, concentrating on a nice long spine. We're breathing. Our head is up, chest is forward, hands are up in the air, legs are up in the air. And then we practice good control, dropping one leg at a time. Nice. All right, so a nice static hold on our core, keeping our spine nice and long, controlling that drop. All right, all right, all right. And then we're on to our last round, last round, last round. Here we go, here we go. One more time on the machine. Let's make a count, guys. Let's make a count. Whatever you're doing for this, last time doing it. Let's get it done. A little competition going on between Lindsay and Henry over here. Who could do the more calories? Henry does not want to fall behind and have Lindsay do more calories than he is, she is. So then they get their agreement about how many to do. I think they're doing 30 on this last round. All right, well, that was our buzzer just to keep time so we know how long we've been doing our jump rope for. That's the only reason I have the clock set. All right, last round, guys. How are we all doing out there? Everyone hanging in there? Everyone hanging in there? I hope so. So far, everyone here is on the last round. Looking good, they're looking good. All right, guys. Looking good out there. Looking good. Let's keep it up. Let's keep it up. Circles. All right, nice strong plank, little circles, 10 each direction, 20 total. Back to our ladders now, guys. Back to our ladders. You know the deal. They're getting good at these by now, all right? Straight up, lateral back, lateral switch, 1-2-1, and hopscotch. Exercise, but this is our hand over hand, basically just a crossover, one hand crossing over the next. Back and forth, four times, up two, down two. Nice job. We're getting there. Two more stages. Here we go. Slurpee time. 10 more Slurpees. Let's get it done. Time to get on the giddy up. Oh, and here we go. Henry's adding those push-ups there at the end. That's all right. And it's more of like a tricep push-up with that hand on the ball. You just want to make sure that your back stays nice and straight, nice and strong. We're not doing any kind of swing of the hips. And Henry is looking real good. He's looking real strong. All right. I like it. Getting 10 of them in. Nice. Finish up our 10 Slurpees. We got a squat with chop. Squat with chop is next. have a Bosu. The goal is to be standing on that thing on the black side and squat and chop at the same time. So it's kind of like a stepping slasher, but we're not stepping, we're squatting. Same thing though, slashing, chopping, same kind of motion. Nice job, nice job, nice job. That looks good, that looks good. Again, no ball, just stand on the ground. Squatting and chopping is totally cool. That's it, that's it, that's it. Looking good, looking good. Almost done, guys, almost done. And then we finish our last round. We have jump rope for time. Jump rope for time, and then hollow body rock. That'll be it. That'll be it. Good work, good work, good work. All right, crank out that jump rope. Time, how much time you got? How much time you got? Well, we are 58 minutes into when we started, so we got 2 more minutes left. So get your 90 seconds in and then some hollow body rock, or we'll go a little bit over. It's all right to go a little bit over. No big deal. We got time, we got time. Good. Cranking out the cardio at the end. Cranking out the cardio at the end. Nice job, nice job, nice job. Woo, ready. All right, and we finish with a hollow body rock. Hollow body rock. Here we go. 20 little reps. So we're going to go forward and back for one. So the heels touch, that is a rep. The heels touch, that's 2 reps. 20 times. Right, keeping the head up, chest up. Try not to use your momentum so much as your core. You go back and forth, roll up onto the shoulders, all the way down to the hips, along your legs, along the arms. More work the core is gonna do. Nice work, nice work, nice work. You got it, guys. You got it. Nothing like a little core activity to finish the day up. Nice job. Nice job. You got this. You got this. You got this. Oh, fight through it. Fight through it. Come on. Oh, I can see the struggle. I can see the struggle is real. The struggle is real. Woo! 20? Nope. Nice. All right. Thumbs up from Henry. That is all she wrote, guys. Well, that is a full workout right there for you. I hope you guys enjoyed it. It was fun bringing it to you. Fast Friday. We've been a while since we had a good one. So, yeah, that was fun. Make sure we stretch over this weekend. You guys want to do it again? We were right ahead, but hopefully a nice weekend to get outside, get some jogging, biking, rollerblading, hiking, whatever the case may be. Either way, it was fun bringing this to you. And we will see you on Monday. Thanks, guys.